So intervals is basically the distance between two notes, and we have already learned two types of intervals. One is a semitone and the other one is tone. Now coming to semitone, it's also called the half step, denoted by the alphabet H, and it's basically the shortest distance between two notes. For example, you have A to A sharp, or B to C, E to F is a half step, or C to C sharp is a half step. Now coming to tone intervals, it's also called the whole step, and it's denoted by the alphabet W. It's two half steps put together. So G to A is a good example. So G to G sharp is a half step, G sharp to A is another half step. So two half steps put together, it's a whole step. So we have basically learned two intervals so far, and if you notice, in music there are around 12 notes. That's A, B, C, D, F, and G, and you have A sharp, C sharp, D sharp, F sharp, and G sharp. We have learned the interval names from A to A sharp and A to B. Now we are going to learn the interval names between A to C, A to C sharp, A to D sharp, until A to G sharp. So we'll learn the interval names, and we'll also see where we can actually use them. So intervals are basically measured using half steps. So the unit of measurement for an interval is a half step. Now in guitar, if you notice, it's easy to identify half steps with each fret. So if, same case, I start with E, have F, F sharp, G, G sharp, it's all moving in half steps. And we would have heard people say there are only 7 notes in music, whereas there's actually 12, including all the sharp notes, if you notice. The reason behind saying there's only 7 notes is very simple. There's actually only 7, A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. Let's take a root note, which is A. We'll take A as a starting point, or it's called a reference note, it's all the same. So I take A as a reference note, the root note, and the second interval from A will be B, A, B. And the third interval from A will be an A, B, C. And the fourth interval from A is A, B, C, D. And fifth interval from A is A, B, C, D, E. Sixth interval is F. 7th interval is G, and the 8th interval again, it's going to become an octave. So now we know that there are only 7 notes, then what are these sharp notes called? Why do they exist? It's because these are basically subcategories. So we have A, and there can be only one root note, only one starting point, one note where we can start from. So there's no subcategory for A, that's a root note. Second note, if you notice, it's a B, and the subcategory is a B flat. So there's a B and a B flat, two types of seconds. Third interval, which is a C, you have C and a C sharp, two types of thirds. And these intervals are basically categorized into a major interval and a minor interval. So for a second, you have major second, minor second, major third, minor third, and likewise for all the other intervals as well. So we'll take a closer look into it. Now using the notes on a major scale, we'll learn the intervals first. So, for example, we'll take the A major. You know this already. So, the starting point here is the A. It's also called the root note, which means starting point or the reference note. It's also called the unison, U-N-I-S-O-N, which means this is the point we start from. So, from A, the second note of an A major is B. So which becomes a second interval, and this is a major second interval. So from A to B is a major second interval, and the next note in an A major is a C sharp. So between A to C sharp, it's a major third interval. So it's unison, major second, and major third. So next note is going to be a D. So you can either play A to D here, or you can play the D here, it's all the same, because the number of semitones between A to D is all going to be the same regardless of wherever you play. So it's going to be A, A sharp, B, C, C sharp, D. So even if you play the D here, the number of semitones from A is going to be the same. So from A to D, it's called a perfect fourth interval. We'll be learning why it's called a perfect fourth in the upcoming lessons. So just remember, it's a perfect fourth. The next note in an A major scale is an E. So it's just the fifth interval, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the fifth interval is called the perfect fifth. So there's two perfects, perfect fourth and perfect fifth. The next note, which is an F sharp, so from A to F sharp, it's a major sixth interval. Next note in an A major scale is a G sharp, so it will obviously become the major seventh interval. So from A to G sharp is a major seventh interval. And the next note is an A, which is the octave. So we'll revise it once again, it's going to be unison. Between A to B, it's a major second. Between A to C sharp, it's a major third. Between A to D, perfect fourth. A to E is perfect fifth. A to F sharp is major sixth. A to G sharp is major seven. A to the next A is the octave. So again, same example, our starting point is going to be A. So this time there's two types of seconds. One is a major second, the other one is a minor second. And it's easy to remember. We know the major second already. So between A to B, it's a major second interval. If you flatten the B, it's a minor second interval. So A to B flat is a minor second. A to B is major second. So same way for a third, we play a C sharp. Major third is a C sharp. From A minor third is the flattened note, which is a C. So A to C is a minor third interval. So it's unison, minor second, major second, minor third, major third. So it's going in alternatives of minor, major. So between A to D, we already know there's perfect fourth. So the next note after the perfect fourth, in between perfect fourth and perfect fifth, we have a note here that's called the sharp four or the flat five interval. It's not major or minor, it's just a sharp four or a flat five. It's also called the augmented fourth or diminished fifth. We'll come to that later. Just remember, it's a sharp four because you're sharpening the fourth or you're flattening the fifth. So A to D sharp interval is called the sharp four or flat five. The next interval we know it's a perfect fifth. Now there are two types of sixth. You have the major sixth, which is F sharp, minor sixth, which is the F. Two types of Fs. Going to the next note, which is the G sharp in a major scale. A to G sharp is a major seventh. And again, there's two types of seventh, major seven and minor seven. For a minor seven, you flatten the major seven. So between A to G, the interval is a minor 7 interval. So unison, minor 2nd, major 2nd, minor 3rd, major 3rd, perfect 4, sharp 4 or flat 5, perfect 5th, minor 6, major 6, minor 7, major 7,